Hello everyone, in this video we will cover the section 6.6, which is the last section of the chapter 6. In this section we will see the convolution integral or convolution product and its Laplace transform. So sometimes it is possible to identify a Laplace transform as the product of two other transforms, bigger f of s and g of s, and the latter transforms corresponding to noun functions little f and g respectively. In this event we may anticipate that the function bigger h of s would be the transform of the product of little f and g. However, this is not the case. In other words, the Laplace transform cannot be commuted with ordinary multiplication. On the other hand, if an appropriately defined generalized product is introduced, then the situation changes as stated in the following theorem. So this theorem explains how we can obtain the Laplace transform of some function which is the product of two functions of s, like f times g. You see, bigger h of s is equal to bigger f times bigger g, and we consider the Laplace transform of some function of t which is denoted by little h of t, and also we know the Laplace transform of little f is equal to bigger f of s, and similarly we have the same situation for the function little g. And to find the product of them, so little h is defined in terms of little f and g such that it is equal to the integral from 0 to t of the product of the functions little f and g, and f of t minus tau and g of tau d tau, or we write f of tau times g t minus tau d tau. The function little h defined here is known as the convolution of a little f and g, or the convolution product of little f and g. And the integrals in this equation are known as convolution integrals. Okay, to obtain a multiplication of two functions, a product of two functions for the Laplace transform, so we need to define the function little h in this form. Okay, and according to this theorem, the transform of the convolution of two functions rather than the transform of their ordinary product, namely f times g, we don't find the Laplace transform of the ordinary product of two functions which are little f and g, but we find the Laplace transform of the convolution product of them. Okay, so the transform of the convolution of two functions is given by the product of the separate transforms. You see, f times g. It is conventional to emphasize that the convolution integral can be thought of as a generalized product, since we obtain a product of two functions for its Laplace transform. Therefore, we say the integral as a generalized product by writing f convolution product g. Okay? This is defined by one of the integrals written here. Generally, we use the first one for defining the generalized product or convolution integral or convolution product of the functions little f and g. So it is equal to integral from 0 to t f of t minus tau, f of t minus tau, times g of tau d tau. Okay, this integral is denoted by in this form. Okay, with the symbol this one. Okay, in particular, the notation serves to indicate the first integral appearing in this equation. Okay, as I said, the convolution integral is generally denoted by this one. Okay, and we have some properties for the convolution product. The convolution has many of the properties of ordinary multiplication. For example, it is relatively simple to show that we have the commutativity property, we have a distributive law, namely we can distribute the convolution operation over the addition, you see, or instead of addition you can write the subtraction. And we have the associativity property for the convolution integral. Namely, we can change the parentheses. We can change the place of the parentheses, you see. When we have a convolution product of three functions. And the convolution of a function and the zero function is equal to zero. The proofs of these properties can be obtained by just using the definition, you can see easily, since we have the commutativity property for the ordinary product. Also we can say we have the commutativity property for the convolution product. Okay, many of them can be obtained from the definition, you see. However, there are other properties of ordinary multiplication that the convolution integral does not have. For example, it is not true in general that f convolution 1 is equal to f. This is actually the property of the ordinary product, but when we consider the convolution product, we don't have the same property written here. To see this, let's use the definition. The convolution of little f and the number 1, which is considered as a constant function. So we write f of t minus tau times 1. Instead of g, we have 1. And from here we have f of t minus tau d tau, which means this is not equal to f generally. Okay. Sometimes we may get this equality, but generally we don't have this equality. Okay. For example, when we consider cosine t for f, so from this one we obtain it is equal to the integral from 0 to t. Instead of this one we write cosine t minus tau d tau, and the integral will be minus sine t minus tau from 0 to t. After writing the limit points of the integral for the variable, so we obtain sine t, which means the convolution of f and 1 is not equal to f. Okay. Similarly, it may not be true that f convolution f is non-negative. Normally, when we consider the ordinary product, we know f square is always bigger than or equal to 0. This is non-negative. But when we consider the convolution product, so we don't have this property. Okay. We have many properties of the ordinary product for the convolution product, but some properties are not valid for convolution product, like this one or this one. Okay. For example, compute the convolution product. By the way, let's summarize the subject again. So our aim is actually to find the convolution, the Laplace transform of the convolution product. Okay, f convolution g. So it is equal to bigger f of s times g of s, or you can write it is equal to, or let's write first this one. Okay. it is equal to the multiplication of the Laplace transform of the functions little f and g. Okay. Namely, to find the Laplace transform of the convolution integral of the functions f and g, it is enough to find the multiplication of the Laplace transforms of the functions little f and g. Okay. Or we can write, you know, this is equal to bigger f of s times g of s. Conversely, if you want to find the inverse Laplace transform of the product of two functions, bigger f of s times g of s, this is very useful property for the inverse Laplace transform. So it is equal to the convolution of the functions little f and g, okay? Or you can write the inverse Laplace transform of bigger f, convolution product, the inverse Laplace transform of bigger g, okay? Which means we have actually the integral from 0 to t f of t minus tau g of tau d tau. Okay, this is the important property for the inverse Laplace transform. Compute the convolution product of f and g defined by t and t squared respectively. According to the definition, we write the integral. So f of t minus tau will be t minus tau, since we have t here. Instead of t, we write t minus tau. And g of tau will be tau square, okay, from the definition. And from here, we have t times tau square minus tau to the power 3. And after writing the integral easily, and writing the limit points from 0 to t, namely, so we obtain this one, okay? T to the power 4 over 12. Just we compute the integral for finding the convolution of two functions. Find the inverse transform, which is another example. Find the inverse transform of the function bigger h of s, which is defined by a, which is a constant, over a squared times a squared plus a square. So it is convenient to think of this function as the product of 1 over a square and a times a square plus a square, which according to the lines, namely, we consider this is the product of two functions, 1 over a square times a over a square plus a square. Why? Because if we consider this function as a product of two functions, and if you know the Laplace transform, inverse Laplace transform of the functions here, so easily we can find its inverse Laplace transform by using the convolution product. If we consider the first one as bigger f of s and the second one g of s, bigger g of s, so the convolution product of them, namely the inverse Laplace transform of bigger h of s, will be the inverse Laplace transform of the product of them, which means from the formula, it is equal to the convolution of f and g, little f and g, little f and g. What is little f and little g? They are the inverse Laplace transform of them. Okay. Therefore, let's write here bigger f of s is equal to 1 over s squared, and g of s is equal to a over s squared plus a square. and the inverse Laplace transform of bigger F is equal to, you know, t. If we consider the Laplace transform of the power function, if you remember, and the Laplace transform of the second one is equal to, if you remember, so this is equal to sine a times t. Therefore, from the formula here, the Laplace transform of the given function bigger h is the equal to the inverse Laplace transform of the multiplication of bigger f and g, which is equal to the convolution of, so this is little f of t, and this one is equal to g of t, little f convolution g of t, which means it is equal to integral from 0 to t, 0 to t, f of t minus tau, g of tau, d tau. So from here we have integral from 0 to t, f of t minus tau is t minus tau, times g of tau, namely sine a tau d tau. Okay, after computing the integral by using the integration by parts, you will see, namely this one, t minus tau sine a tau d tau, which is equal to this one, which means the inverse Laplace transform of this one, which is the given function, is equal to a times t minus sine a t over a squared, easily without using the partial fraction expansion of this rational function, using the inverse, the Laplace transform of the convolution integral, we obtain the inverse Laplace transform, you see. Also, we can obtain, if we can verify that the same result is obtained if h of t, little h of t, is written in the alternate form, namely instead of bigger f, 1 over a square, we can write a over a square plus a square, and instead of this one for g, we can write also 1 over a square. In this case, we obtain this one, and when we compute the integral, we get this one. Also, it can be found by expanding the given function in partial fractions, but this is long way. Easily, we can find in its inverse Laplace transform by using the convolution integral. Find the solution of the initial value problem. The second derivative plus 4 times y is equal to g of t with initial conditions y of 0 is equal to 3, and the derivative at the same point is equal to minus 1. And we don't know exactly clearly the definition of g of t, but how can we find the solution of this differential equation in terms of little g? So by taking the Laplace transform of the differential equation and using the initial conditions, we obtain this one. Bigger g of s is the Laplace transform of the right side of the equation. Little g of t, and the left side of this equation is obtained by using the Laplace transform of the second derivative. If you remember, a square times bigger y, here bigger y of S is the Laplace transform of the solution function. S squared times the Laplace transform of Y minus 3 times S, namely S times Y0, and Y prime of 0 minus Y prime of 0, which means it is equal to plus 1. Okay, you know the formula for the second derivative, and from this formula we obtain this term, and the second term is corresponding to this one, you know, and that's it. And let's find bigger y of s, which is equal to the addition of the terms written here, you see. So the Laplace transform of the solution function is equal to the addition of two terms written here. Observe that the first and second terms on the right side of the equation written here, the first and second terms, contain the dependence of bigger y of s on the initial conditions and forcing function respectively. It is convenient to write bigger y s in the form to make easier the calculation of the inverse transform of this one, because we can obtain the solution of the differential equation by taking the inverse transform of the right side of the equation. So considering the terms in the numerator for the first one separately, which means we distribute the denominator to each term in the numerator, so we obtain 3 times s over s squared plus 4 minus, so we have s squared plus 4 in the denominator, which means 4 is 2 squared, and we should obtain the square root of this one in the numerator to use the formula for sine t for its inverse Laplace transform, if you remember. Therefore, 1 over a square plus 4 is equal to 1 over 2 times 2 over a square plus 4. Okay, for this one now directly we can find its inverse transform, which is equal to sine 2t, since we have the number 2 in the numerator, writing like this. And similarly for the last one, we have again 1 over 2 times 2 over s squared plus 4 times bigger g of s, and you see we have a product of two functions for the last one. When we consider the first one, we have 3 times cosine 2t, okay, cosine 2t minus 1 over 2 times sine 2t, you see, plus 1 over 2 times, so this is corresponding to bigger f of s, and we have also g of s. So if you want to find the inverse transform of the product of two functions, as we can see, we use the convolution integral. Okay, so the inverse Laplace transform of the last one will be the convolution of little f and g. Okay, little f is the inverse Laplace transform of this one, which is equal to sine 2t, and according to the definition we should write f of t minus tau. So when write t minus tau for t for this one, we obtain this one, sine 2 times t minus tau times g of tau d tau. This is the solution of the differential equation, and this is written in terms of little g of tau. If you know clearly its definition, so we can find the solution of the differential equation. Okay, if you don't know clearly the function which is on the right side of the differential equation, so we can find still the solution of this differential equation by using the convolution integral, convolution product, as you can see in this example. Another example: use the convolution theorem to compute this Laplace transform. So from the definition of the convolution product, you see the definition. So we see that this one is actually the convolutional product of the functions exponential t and t. Okay, so we have t minus tau for the power of the number e, which means it is corresponding to little f, since we have t minus tau here, and the remaining term is corresponding to the other function. Therefore, f of t is e to the power t, g of t is equal to t, since we have tau here. By the convolution theorem, it is equal to the Laplace transforms of the functions little f and g, you know, the Laplace transform of the convolution product is equal to the Laplace transform of little f times the Laplace transform of little g. Therefore, we write the Laplace transform of the integral in here as the Laplace transforms of the corresponding functions as a multiplication, you see. The Laplace transform of e to the power t is equal to 1 over s minus 1, you know. And the second one is equal to 1 over s squared by using the formula for the power function, which means we have this one, okay, easily. Another example, solve the integral equation written here, y of t plus the integral from 0 to t, and you see the term is equal to 1, okay? Namely, what is y? What is y? Can you find the clear definition of y from this equality? So we use Laplace transforms and convolutions, so you can see clearly this integral is actually the convolution product of the functions t and y of t. G of t is corresponding to this one, and f of t minus tau is corresponding to this one, f of t minus tau, and this one corresponding to g of t. We write f convolution product g, where f of t is equal to t, because just we have t minus tau. Therefore, the integral equation becomes in this form. Taking the Laplace transform of both sides, we obtain the Laplace transform of y plus the Laplace transform of the convolution is equal to the Laplace transform of 1, and from here we obtain the Laplace transform of y using the formula. This one is equal to the product of the Laplace transforms of the corresponding functions f and g. The right side is equal to 1 over s, and from here the Laplace transform of this one is equal to 1 over s squared, and by simple algebra we can find the Laplace transform of y, which is equal to this one, and y of t is the inverse Laplace transform of this one, which means from the formula table we have cosine t for y of t. Okay, that's it. Another example, find a formula for the solution to the initial value problem written here. We have the third derivative plus 4 times first derivative is equal to little f of t with initial conditions written here. So we will find a formula for the solution to the initial value problem written here in terms of the convolution product. Because we don't know the clear definition of little f, therefore we will benefit from the convolution product to find the formula for the solution. So we use the Laplace transform always. Taking the Laplace transform of both sides for the equation, so we obtain this one. Using the derivative formulas, we obtain this one for the third derivative. For the first derivative, we use this one. Okay, we have this one, and the right side is equal to bigger f of s, which is the Laplace transform of little f. Okay, and from here, using the initial conditions, you see, and considering the coefficients of the Laplace transform of the solution function, so we obtain after some simple algebra as 1 over s plus, so this is equal to 1 over s times plus bigger f of s over s times a square plus 4, a square plus 4. Therefore, little y of t will be the inverse transform of the right side of the equation, which means we take the inverse transform of this one. So we can easily find the inverse Laplace transform of the first term, which is equal to 1, okay? And the second one is obtained by using the convolution product. If we consider this term as product of two functions, the first one is bigger f of s, the second one is the remaining term. So if you write for the second one as bigger h of s, so the inverse Laplace transform of them will be equal to the convolution of little f and h, such that little f is the inverse Laplace transform of bigger f, little h is the inverse Laplace transform of this one, which is bigger h. Okay, so we write the solution of the differential equation as 1 plus the convolution product of little f and little h, and little h, as I said, is the inverse Laplace transform of this one, and using the partial fraction decomposition for this one, we obtain this thing, and its inverse Laplace transform is equal to 1 over 4 minus 1 over 4 times cosine 2t. Okay, you can find easily, and you see the clear computation for this one to find the partial fraction expansion. Okay, so little f convolution h will be equal to this one. Therefore, we obtain y of t is equal to 1 over 1 plus 1 over 4 integral from 0 to t f of 2 times 1 minus cosine 2 t minus 2 d 2, since we find little h. Okay, so this formula allows us to express the output y of t of the input-output system in terms of the input. Output is obtained in terms of the input, little f of t. Such formulas are used in control problems to produce a desired output by adjusting the input appropriately, namely by writing mini input values, so we obtain outputs, and among them we find the desired output, and also after finding the desired output, we find the corresponding input by using this formula. Okay, therefore the convolution product is important for you. Thank you very much.